Hello children, how are you? I hope you all are fine at home. Today we will do something from the writing section, that is the composition. The topics we will be dealing today will be formal letter and paragraph writing. So let us first start with a formal letter. The definition of a formal letter is, a formal letter is a letter to principals of schools and colleges and to official bodies. Means whenever we are writing any letter to any office, or like you are writing a letter to your principal, sir, then it becomes a formal letter. Let us see the format of a formal letter. The format of formal letter goes like this. You have first the sender's address. The person who is writing the letter will write his own address, followed by the date, that is DDM month and year, followed by receiver's address, means the person who will be receiving the letter, that person's address will be there. Then we have the subject. We have to mention the purpose of writing the letter over there, followed by the salutation, that is sir or madam you can address. If the person is the person to whom you are writing is sir, then you may address as sir, or if the person is a female one, you may address her as madam. Then we have the body of letter, that is what we call content of letter. Then you have the subscription. Last one is the subscription, where we end the letter by writing yours faithfully or yours sincerely, followed by the person's name who has written the letter, class, section, roll number, you have to mention if you are writing to the principal of your school. Then everything should be written on the left hand side of the page. Let us see the example of formal letter. The question is, write a letter to the principal of your school requesting him to exempt from game period since you have got badly injured in your right leg. Exempt means you are not participating in game spirit. So we will be dealing with three parts, part 1, part 2, part 3. So let us see part 1. Here first we are writing the sender's address. Suppose you are writing the letter to the principal, then your address will be there on the top, then followed by the date, like 24th of April 2020, followed by the receiver's address, that is you are writing to the principal, so you will write the principal, Kerley School, Sector 2, Dhurwa, Ranchi 4. Next comes part 2, is your salutation, that is, sorry, followed by, first one will be subject, that what is the purpose of writing the letter. So it should be very clear, the subject part. So you will write like request to exempt from games period for 1 week. So you want 1 week rest, you don't have to play for 1 week, so you are writing that letter. So salutation is sir, then body of the letter, like as I have already written here, you may see, with due respect, I, Atul Kumar of class 5A, would like to inform you that yesterday I got badly injured in my right leg. The doctor has advised me not to run or play for at least a week as the injury may become more complicated. So I request you to kindly exempt me from the games period for 1 week. I'll remain grateful to you for this kind favor of yours. So down you end the letter by a thanking note, that is thanking you. The part 3 is a conclusive part, where you are concluding, what we call a subscription. So you write yours faithfully, and please take care that in yours there is no apostrophe to be used. Atul Kumar, you have mentioned the class, section and roll number. So this way the letter has to be written. Next topic we will see is the paragraph writing. So let us define what is a paragraph. A paragraph is a number of sentences, so it consists of lots of sentences which are grouped together and relating to one topic. So the topic will be on the top, which will be related to it only. How many sentences it will be there, or a group of related sentences that develop a single point. So a paragraph must have a heading. It should always have a heading or caption using capitalized. So it should be in the capital form. A paragraph should have an introductory sentence. So when we start any paragraph, it should introduce about the topic. It should tell something about the topic and a concluding sentence, which will be again a conclusion part about the topic. The format of paragraph writing. See here, we have been given the clues, like various points which can be used to develop into a paragraph. So these are the, where you have a small dash, it doesn't mean you have to fill up or something. These are different hints, like site of the village market is one hint, difference between a heart and a market is another point, various kinds of shops. So you have got different points which you have to elongate and you have to develop into various sentences. So here is a format, like we are starting with a village market, that is the heading. So you may find we have written with the capital letter, and so we have already written the paragraph. So you may go through it and you may find that how we have developed it. So the village market may be termed as the heading, which is written in capital letter. Then we have the introductory sentence. Now introductory sentence means about the topic. So a village market is held in open space in the center of the surrounding village. So we are telling what is a village market. So it's an introductory sentence. Then at last we have the concluding sentence, that is we are concluding the paragraph. Thus a village market bears a vital importance in the life of villagers. So these three things are very important whenever you write a paragraph. So children, today I hope you all have learned the format very nicely, and today I am going to give you homework where you are going to write a letter and a paragraph. The first question is that you have to write a letter to the principal of your school requesting for 3 days sickness leave, and second is a paragraph on a book fair. So you will find I have given you certain hints, or you may say the points which you have to develop into a paragraph. Okay, so you may use these hints and develop into a paragraph. So please keep it in mind when you write about the format and rules how to write a letter. And you are supposed to write in your grammar copy. Okay, you divide your copy into two halves. For writing section, keep less number of pages in the middle, and you may write the examples also which I have given along with the questions which you have to do, and use pen. Till then, thank you.